I don't believe that.
The air in the silk foundation mixes with ultra-fine mesh. Tiny particles of silk cover the skin completely, creating a beautiful, smooth, natural appearance. And you'll be using up to 10 times less makeup than liquid foundations applied with your fingers. Oh. So instead of exaggerating wrinkles and pores, with Lumines, you virtually turn back time, looking dramatically younger fast. With Lumines, I'm using about 10 times less makeup. Now turn this on.
One hungry one.
Hey, Jill. You know what I tell girls?
What?
Well, some girls. I tell them, don't call a boy ugly. Because at least he doesn't use makeup.
Jacob.
You're too off.
Acidic and aren't necessarily great for your teeth. The acid can actually wear away at the enamel, which over time can cause sensitivity, and a lot of people start to see their teeth turn yellow. I like to recommend Pronamel to my patients to help them protect their teeth and keep the enamel strong.
Do you do instruments? Instruments.
Very similar to rock science, actually.
Gloss is now in session. The series premiere of Making It Home, Monday night at 9 on HGTV and HGTV Go.
Michael Oppie has survived brain surgery to remove a glass object embedded in his brain.
You never really know how the surgery has gone until the patient wakes up and you know that for a fact he's clinically doing well.
I
didn't know whether Michael was going to be Michael or be someone else, or, you know, just a zombie. And it scared me. I squeezed his hand, and I said, "Are you in pain?" And he squeezed my hand back, which meant yes. And I said, "Can you think? You have a brain, can you think?" He said, "Yes." And I said, "Can you see me?" He said, "Yes." But he squeezed my hand, and then I laid my cheek on his cheek, and I told him I loved him.
How can he seize you when you're asleep?
That will be traumatizing. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
How much you want to bet some of them are traumatized after that instinct?
Yeah, no thanks. I'm good.
I will mute it.
Thank you.
There's one that is it called touch tube, and it goes in one that's right here.
And then we'll have no airway.
Yeah.
And there was also one that is called IO.
Mm-hmm.
Well, usually them do it if we're close to dead or unconscious. And what them do is drill into the bone and put an IV deal.
Thank you.
I've got you. I got this call now.
Hello, I'm an examiner.
200 meters.
But years ago, I was diagnosed with a sleep disorder.
226. Seven.
Out of their house or something.
Mm-hmm.
This, they live with I forgot which couple. But it's like
Student Cummings could still be on the verge of death, even though Dr. Linda Chasiakos has managed to cut him down.
She got a nosebleed.
Yeah, because when he was hanging,
he kicked
him by her.
I just wanted to hug him, just to reassure both myself and him that he was still here on Earth and that he hadn't moved on. I think that after having been in practice for a while, there was a part of me.
Got from me.
We're all sort of looking at each other momentarily.
Dr. Nunu Telegani is about to bend the hospital rules to save the life of her newest patient, a dog named Scribbles.
Maybe he had a seizure.
Blood
wouldn't cause a seizure now, would it? I mean, if it did, then he...
Then the dog...
Oh, daddy.
Them gone. Poke.
Oh, I thought they were gonna...
Cut? Yeah, a dog being cardiac arrest ain't gonna do that. I mean, he probably had a seizure or fainted.
That she was like, I got who are you?
Part of the beauty of the emergency department and working as an emergency physician is you see all comers. You know, old, young, wealthy, homeless.
Dogs.
And in this case, canine, human. You see anything and anybody that walks in the door, you will treat them the same.
My question is though, why is there blood everywhere?
Because he
was at a dog park.
Oh, no.
Oh, this is a reenactment. So, whatever happens here is
really
gonna happen.
So, it's fake.
Yeah.
In his face, paramedic Ralph Nero does everything in his power to try and defuse the situation.
Is that like the security chief's police job? Like,
dead.
Carvana's had a lot of firsts. 100% online car buy, car vending machines, and now. It's hard made up numbers. It's what you'll really pay, right down to the penny. Whether you're shopping or just looking, it only takes a few seconds and it won't affect your credit score. Finally, a totally different way to finance your ride.
$2.95.
very similar to rocket science fiction.
Class is now in session. The set is premiere, making it home Monday night at 9 on HDTV and HDTV.
People will die if they call on that.
Ralph Miro is doing everything in his power to attempt to reason with a gun-wielding patient.
They're making a scene to a human. It's okay. I will hear how they are.
Officers rather were very sharp and moved very quickly.
Oh, the patient zip tied him.
Uh huh. Get him in cuffs. Don't go.
Yeah.
I want to know.
I mean, I would ask the police party some years later, but that's it.
If Dr. Heather Crane cannot quickly break up the blood clot that has moved from his leg to his lung, Archer will die.
I think the strange thing about being an ER doc is you come into somebody's life in a moment where they're in complete crisis. They are broken down, they're crying, they're not handling things well. It's an extremely intimate moment.
Dr. Crane breaks hospital protocol and accompanying John Archer out of the ER. She wants to be with her patients.
Yeah, that's what
Backflip times three.
Dr. Heather Crane works fast to save the life of John Archer. For her, he's not just another cancer survivor. He's a very witty man she has brought to life.
The clotbusters, they're not just something to get out of the fridge. You gotta mix them up. You gotta get ready to give. Nurses are working on this. And we're doing everything we can for the patient. Finally, we got them all mixed up. We're all ready to go. We go ahead and put it in an IV and we push it in. And we wait to see what's going to happen. And
300.
307.
Dr. Crane will not be able to stay with this patient. She's already broken hospital protocol by leaving the emergency room.
For the end of my shift, I need to go get some food because I've been running around like a chicken with a head cut off all day.
Dr. Crane?
Me? Oh, I'm not.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry to interrupt your lunch.
No!
Oh,
yeah. I said, what? I just, and I said, how are you doing? And I was kind of
kind of scared to ask a question. I didn't know what had happened. I didn't know how you were doing.
It's okay. He seems to be resting okay. And that's good. Well, he was definitely a fighter, but I knew that made it.
So it was kind of nice for me to be able to hear about my patients. A lot of times, you see him in the ER, and then that's about it. We don't get a lot of follow-up on them. We don't get to hear what happens. Sometimes, we don't get to hear whether they make it or not. I couldn't sleep after the night shift. I just couldn't sleep because it was great.